Myself is Dr. Reema Sinha. Presently, I am working as associate professor in the Department of Pharmacy, Rami's Institute of Vocational and Technical Education. This institute is affiliated to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, Lucknow. Student, today I am going to give a lecture on the introduction of histamine and antihistamine agents, which is your part of your syllabus of Medicinal Chemistry 2, which code is BP501T. Friends, in this lecture, I will discuss the introduction part of antihistaminic agent. Before going to start antihistaminic agent, I would like to discuss about the introduction of histamine. Here I will discuss what is histamine, what is the chemical structure of histamine, and how histamine is biosynthesized from histidine. So, I will discuss and give the chemical reactions involving the biosynthesis of histamine. Then I will discuss histamine receptor. There is 4 types of receptors that I will discuss in this lecture, and distribution of various receptors in our body, location of receptor in our body, I will give in your tabular form. Then I will discuss the symptom when histamine is interact with receptor, what you feel. After that, I will discuss the introduction of antihistaminic agent. Here I will define definition of antihistaminic agent, what is the purpose for using of antihistaminic agent, and what are the drugs generally we are using antihistaminic agent. Besides this, I will also discuss the uses of antihistaminic agents, and lastly I will cover the side effects of antihistaminic agents. So, first I will start histamine, that is histamine. You should know what is histamine. Histamine, if you break the histamine word, that is histose or amine. Just you see here, histose means, histose means tissue, and amines means amino group. So, histamine basically it is a tissue amine. Chemically it is known as beta imidazolyl ethyl amine derivatives, which is found in all tissues of the human body. Here you see the structure histamine. Just you see the structure of histamine. It contains this part, which is known as imidazole, and this part, which is known as ethyl chain. Here it contains 2 carbon, so it is ethyl chain. Next is your amino group. So, if you nomenclature this, like alpha, this carbon alpha and this carbon beta, then it will nomenclature as beta imidazolyl ethyl amine. You can nomenclature by putting the number system also, like 1 and 2. Suppose, if you are putting here 1, suppose you are putting here 1 and this is 2, then it is known as 2 imida zolyl ethyl amine. So, histamine is 2 imidazole ethyl amine. Basically, it is endogenous substances. It was first discovered by scientists Windaus and Vogt in 1907. You must be knowing histamine is stored in secretary granules of mast cell, and the function of histamine is act as an autocoag. You must be knowing the meaning of autocoag. In our body there is so many individual substances with different structure and diversified different pharmacological activity are present in our body, but their pharmacological action will not permit to group in a one class like hormones or neurohormones. So, they are classified or categorized in a different group under the name of autocoag, right. Autocoag ka meaning you can see here, auto means self and ecos means remedy, or you can say drug or medicine. So, histamine act as a autocoag, is function as an autocoag. Now, how histamine synthesized from histidine? So, here you see the biosynthesis of histamine. So, you see the structure of histidine here, and this is the structure of histamine. Histamine is biosynthesized from histidine in the presence of enzyme histidine decarboxylase enzyme, histidine decarboxylase enzyme, by the process decarboxylation. Just you see the reaction here, this is the histidine reaction. Here you see the histidine reaction, it also contains histidine imidazole. Imidazole ring, 5 membered ring, and there is 2 nitrogen which are at the 1 and 3 position. So, it also contains imidazole ring, and there is 2 carbon ethyl chain, and it also contains amino group, and this is your carboxylic group. So, this is the basic structure of histidine. After decarboxylation, it forms histamine and CO2 will liberate. Just to compare the structure, it also contains imidazole, ethyl side chain and amino group, only left is your carboxylic group. So, CO2 group is evolved. So, this is the how histamine is biosynthesized from histidine. So, these are the reaction which explain the biosynthesis of histamine. Now, we will move to histamine receptor. Once histamine released from mast cell, it will bind with receptor. What are those receptors? You must know there is 4 types of receptors. Histamine receptor, it is classified into 4 types. One is your H1 receptor, another is your H2, next is your H3 receptor and H4 receptor. So, in our body there is a 4 type of histamine receptor present. Now, see the location of various histamine receptor in our body. See this table, I have given you in a tabular form, so that you can remember easily. See location of H1 receptor, it is brain, GIT, gastrointestinal tract, cardiovascular, lymphocytes. Now, the location of H2 receptor in our body, main organ, that is your heart, uterus, vascular smooth muscle cells. Now, the location of H3 receptor, that is your CNS, central nervous system. Now, we come to H4 receptor. H4 receptor is present in thymus cell, small intestine, spleen, colon, bone marrow and basophils. So, So these are the various histamine receptor and their distribution in the human body. So this table will well explain the distribution of histamine receptor in our body. See the images. You just see here mast cell is there, just like a ball structure. There is a granule, that is your histamine. Mast cell release histamine. These are the histamine. Mast cell release histamine. Each mediate through receptor. There is four receptor. So histamine when released from mast cell, it combined with receptor H1, H2, H3, and H4. So there are the images of various organs which contain H1 receptor, H2 receptor, and H3 receptor, and H4 receptor, which I have told in you tabular form. So these are the images. You take the example like H1 receptor. You see, brain, heart, the main organ, smooth vessel cells, like this, all the organs which represent the various receptors. All the histamine receptor belonging to a family G protein coupled receptor. Histamine is chemical messenger communicating information from one cell to another to form various physiological function in our body. So, histamine has a very important role in the body. Most important is that is your anti-allergic reactions and inflammatory response. Another is very important, that is your gastric acid secretion. And next is your neurotransmission in the brain. So, histamine, the role of histamine in our body, first is allergic reactions, next inflammation, next that is your gastric acid secretion and neurotransmission of the brain. So, it has an important role in the allergic, inflammatory, try to remember response and in the regulation of gastric acid secretion. Here you see the action of histamine. When histamine is released from mast cell, it is combined with primarily on the H1 receptor. So, just to take the example of any like smooth muscle of cardiac, it increases the heart rate, decreases the blood pressure. Also, when histamine bind with H1 receptor, it may causes bronchoconstriction and wheeze. Similarly, when you know mast cell is lots of mast cell present under the skin. So, when it bind with H1 receptor, it stimulates sensory nerve ending, which may cause itching. It also causes vasodilation and increased vascular permeability, which may cause erythema and edema. These are the general response of H1 receptor when histamine bind with H1 receptor. When histamine bind to H2 receptor, it will increase the secretion of gastric acid secretion. It stimulates the parietal cell. It increases the gastric acid secretion, which may cause stomach ulcer. Here you see the structure of histamine, which I have discussed in first slide. See the structure of histamine when it bind with receptor, here H1 receptor and H2 receptor. So, main response just I have shown by image, like it may causes bronchoconstriction or it may causes increases bowel persistence or इट मे कॉज इंक्रीजेस वैसोडायलेशन एंड परमेबिलिटी. वन इट बाइंड विथ एस टू रिसेप्टर इट इंक्रीजेस द सिक्रीशन ऑफ एस सी एल सिक्रीशन. सो टू एंटेगोनाइज दिस इफेक्ट ऑफ हिस्टामिन रिसेप्टर वेन बाइंड विथ हिस्टामिन वी आर यूजिंग एंटी हिस्टामिनिक एजेंट ड्रग. सो एंटी हिस्टामिनिक ड्रग्स वाट एंटी हिस्टामिनिक ड्रग विल डू. सो जनरली वी आर डूइंग लाइक फॉर एच वन रिसेप्टर जस्ट आई एम गिविंग यू वन एग्जाम्पल दैट इज योर फेक्सोफेनाडिन. यू मस्ट बी अवेयर द नेम ऑफ एलिग्रा इन कॉमर्शियल ब्रांडेड प्रोडक्ट इन मार्केट विच कंटेन फेक्सोफेनाडिन. फॉर एच वन रिसेप्टर रिस्पॉन्स जनरली वी आर यूजिंग एच वन रिसेप्टर एंटागोनिस्ट. फॉर रिड्यूसिंग द एसिड सिक्रीशन वी आर यूजिंग एच टू रिसेप्टर एंटागोनिस्ट लाइक रानिटिडिन. हियर आई एम मेंशन द रानिटिडिन, फेमोटिडिन, सिमेटिडिन. दीज आर द एच टू रिसेप्टर एंटागोनिस्ट. इफ यू सी द जनरल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस ड्रग दे आर मोस्टली क्लोजली रिजेंबल्स टू हिस्टामिन. वी विल दैट आई विल डिस्कस इन लेटर. सो फर्स्ट आई विल कंप्लीट द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट देन आई विल डिस्कस द स्ट्रक्चर पार्ट ऑल्सो ऑफ एंटी हिस्टामिनिक ड्रग. हेयर यू जस्ट सी द सिम्टम. वाट आर द सिम्टम यू फील? इचिंग. ही इज फीलिंग इचिंग एंड द एक्सप्रेशन यू सी स्टमक अपसेट एंड यू मे फील हेड एक. ऑल्सो यू मे फील ब्लड क्लॉट्स, हार्ट बीट, फ्रीक्वेंट हार्ट बीट. यू विल फील इंक्रीज इन हार्ट रेट एंड स्वेलिंग एंड इन्फ्लामेशन. Swelling and inflammation. Image is also showing. Adrenaline is released. Increase the permeability of the capillary. Also, bronchoconstriction. The major symptoms. Blood vessel to dilate and also gastric acid secretion. When histamine release and bind to receptor, you will feel this symptom. What antihistamine will do? Now, histamine part, introductory part of histamine is over. There we have discussed histamine structure, biosynthesis, various histamine receptor H1, H2. S3, H4 and location of various histamine receptor in our body. And when the histamine comes in contact with receptor, what are the symptoms you feel that I have discussed in the introductory part of histamine. Now, your topic is antihistamine. What is the meaning of antihistamine? Antihistamine drug, what they will do? They will first block the release of histamine from mast cell. They block the histamine release, or antihistamine reduces or eliminate the effect mediated by chemical histamine. They are mostly used to treat, antihistaminic drugs are mostly used to treat allergic or cold and flu symptom which is caused by viral infection. You have seen various dosage form of antihistaminic. It is available in market in the form of tablet, in the form of gel, in the form of capsule, in the form of nasal spray. You have seen atrovine, generally we are using it nasal spray and eye drops. So generally antihistamine, just to discuss, H1 receptor antagonist. Here antihistamine is classified into H1 receptor antagonist and S2 receptor antagonist. In your syllabus, you have to read about the H1 receptor antagonist and S2 receptor antagonist. Just I am mentioning here, it is classified into on the basis of mechanism. First, it blocks the action of histamine. Second, it blocks the action of release histamine also. First, it blocks the action of histamine from mast cell. Then it also blocks the action of release histamine, which mediated through, which give the biological response after binding with histaminic receptors. So, further second classification is classified into H1 receptor antagonist, S2 receptor antagonist. Here you see the general structure of H1 receptor antagonist. Here this is your X and spacer group is there and terminal nitrogen. And here aromatic ring is there, substituted aromatic ring. This is the general structure of H1 receptor antagonist. Now you see the S2 receptor antagonist. Just to compare with the structure of histamine. Here this is the CH2 number of carbon chain and then terminal nitrogen. Just you see here the S2 receptor antagonist drugs, they generally contain a midazole ring, that nucleus is also present in histamine also, and ethyl side chain and terminal nitrogen. So, it antagonizes the function of histamine. Just to compare this structure with histamine. So, it is easy way to remember the general structure of antihistaminic agents. Here H1 receptor antagonist, 2-phenyl ring is joined with X. Here X may be carbon, nitrogen or oxygen. Depending on the substituted item, either it can be carbon, it can be nitrogen, it can be oxygen, it is further sub classified into 7 categories. So, that I will discuss in your classification of antihistaminic agents. Here I am just discussing the basic structure, basic nucleus present in antihistaminic agent, either H1 receptor antagonist or S2 receptor antagonist. So, just to compare this H1 receptor antagonist, X, there is a special group, it may be your carbon chain like CH2, okay. Then S2 receptor antagonist, here imidazole ring is there, ethyl side chain and terminal nitrogen. Now, you come to know about the basic nucleus present in H1 receptor antagonist and S2 receptor antagonist. Now, we compare this structure with histamine. Histamine ka structure, that is also imidazole ring and chain and terminal nitrogen. So, you can compare. So, our first antihistaminic drug is your piperoxane. You see the structure of piperoxane is there. It is discovered by the scientist whose name is Daniel Jeffroy and Daniel Bovet while developing a guinea pig animal model of anaphylaxis. For this work, they have awarded Nobel Prize in the year of 1957. So, this was very important medicine, first drug which was used as antihistaminic drug, piperoxane. You remember the name piperoxane, this is the structure of piperoxane. General mechanism of action, how antihistaminic will work. Just I am discussing a general, I will take one by one mechanism in our further lectures. Here I just general mechanism by which antihistaminic drug work. First, it block the action of histamine receptor. When histamine bind with receptor, it will give biological response. So, it block the action of histamine receptor. Next, it competes histamine with binding, because its basic nucleus is, last slide you have seen, its basic nucleus is resembles to histamine, antihistaminic drug. Third, it displaces histamine from receptor. Receptor ke saath jo bind ho gaya, us histamine ko bhi displace karte hain. So, it is very simple, when you give antihistaminic drug in early stage, you will be more benefited. So, most beneficial when it is given in orally or early. Here you see various antihistaminic drug, why it is used. Antihistaminics are very effective in the treatment of allergic rhinitis. These are the allergic response which is caused by some antigen, and it is also used in the treatment and cold and flu, which is a viral infection. Food allergy, if you are taking some food or you are feeling some allergy, in that case antihistaminic drug is very effective. In case of hay fever, urticaria, or if you are having any hypersensitive reaction to drugs, in that case you are also use antihistaminic drug. Now, insect bites, in case of insect bite, it you can also use antihistaminic drug. And sting, when insect is bite, then you feel sudden pain, in that case you also find use antihistaminic drug. What are the common side effect that antihistaminic drugs are having? Common side effect is headache. You feel headache when you are taking antihistaminic drug, and hypertension, your BP, blood pressure will maybe increase. Difficulty in concentration, you just see the images, you are not able to concentrate on your work, either your home or office. You feel a stomach absent, your stomach is not, your digestion is not properly done. Then you are feeling difficulty in नॉर्मल बॉडी, जो डेली फंक्शंस है वो आप नहीं कर पा रहे हैं. यू आर शोइंग फीलिंग डाउन एंड यू आर फीलिंग ड्राइनेस इन योर माउथ. सो दीज आर द वेरियस सिस्टम कॉमन साइड इफेक्ट. एंड यू आर ऑल्सो फीलिंग ड्राउजीनेस इफ यू आर टेकिंग H1 रिसेप्टर ड्रग फर्स्ट जनरेशन. यू आर फीलिंग ड्राउजीनेस एंड यू आर फीलिंग फैटिग. दीज आर द कॉमन एंटीहिस्टामिनिक साइड इफेक्ट्स व्हेन यू आर टेकिंग दीज ड्रग. सो friends, if you are taking these drugs, you should take care, so not to take too much, and you take with the advice of doctor. So here I have discussed all the antihistaminic drug, introduction of histamine, okay, and introduction of antihistaminic drugs. Thank you.